Flat-packed PC cases are on the rise in today's world of ITX cases. I'm not even sure why. Is it because they are cheaper to make or buy? Are they better quality? Or do they simply offer something beneficial an out-of-box fully ready-to-go PC case doesn't? Today, we will look at the Laser 3D LZ7 XTD ITX case, an IKEA-style flat-packed semi-modular compact PC case that will require you to put together first, before you can put all your beautiful PC components inside. But is this case worth your time and money? Let's find out. So this is the Z27 XTD, made by a company called Laser3D, who are based in the UK and specialize in ITX cases. They're quite unique as they offer these flat-packed ITX cases that you can configure to the style of your choice. For instance, if I chose to buy the LZ7 XTD, I can choose a different shade or style for each of the panels. I can click on the main panel, choose another color like gray, then select the top panel, which seems to have more choice, a small vented solid color panel, clear window, smoky window, fully vented, and a fusion panel, which is part solid color with either a clear or smoky window. So plenty of choice. And then you have other bits and bobs to change, like the side panels, IO type, the frames that hold the panels and case feet, etc. I really like the idea of having the ability to choose different colours and styles. It definitely makes the case more personal to me. So let's have a look at what you get when you unbox this case. And do remember, not everyone is going to have the same materials inside, as it's based on how you configure your design. Here is a quick unboxing. Most of the case is made from acrylic, and some parts wood. That's if you choose the wood effects panels. Everything is neatly organized and safely wrapped in plastic to avoid scratching when you unbox it. And thank God they've made the plastic easy to take off, unlike the Geek A50, which was annoyingly difficult. The Geek A50 is another flat-packed PC case I reviewed a while back. You can click on the link above if you want to check it out. Anyway, back to the LZ7 XTD. The acrylic panels look and feel of a high quality, mainly because the panels are fairly thick, with a bit of weight to them. They are robust, but I wouldn't recommend this case if you plan to use it for portability, as they would surely crack or warp if you put it in a bag along with any hard items. Okay, let's get straight into building this case. After that, I will build all my components into it, run a few games tests to check out the thermals, and find out if this case is any good. Ready? Let's go! Thank you. So that's what it looks like to build a case and build into it. And I can honestly say that that's the first time I've actually enjoyed assembling a Flatpaks PC case. I didn't find it complex or tedious, because there wasn't a lot of bolts and screws needed to stick it together, and it did help that the actual layout was well thought out. It made fitting all the components inside this case super easy, as there was sufficient room in this tiny case, by far one of the easiest RTX cases I've built into. It can fit a CPU cooler with a maximum height of roughly 130mm, and a graphics card length of up to 280mm. My only criticism is that this case is designed with large air vents. This helps promote better airflow, which is great, but I can only imagine inside will become a dust trap over time, since there are no dust filters. You can certainly buy separate dust filters and add them, but aesthetically, it would look weird on the see-through panels, but on the darker panels you probably won't notice them much. But if you don't want to use ugly dust filters, and you don't mind opening the case and cleaning the dust once in a while, then this shouldn't be a problem. Now, let's take a look at the thermal performance for this case. Remember, temps may vary depending on the different panels and components you guys end up using for this case. I played 4 different games at 1440p at 144Hz using G-Sync, with no overclocking and the fan set to an automated fan curve. Here are the results. For a compact case, I'm happy with the results, as both CPU and GPU temps across all games sit below 70 degrees Celsius, except for Rainbow Six, which went above 70 degrees from time to time. Maybe next time I'll use a low profile CPU cooler to allow the slim 120 Noctua fan to push more air in its direction. Or I could have all the case fans to exhaust only. But I'll update you guys on both outcomes, so give me a follow on Instagram for these quick little updates. But overall, very good temps for a case this size, with reasonable fan noise levels when playing games. This case cost around £158, which works out about $197 in the US. It's definitely a little pricey, but then again, everything in the RTX world is quite expensive. But I guess what you're paying for is the quality of the materials, and the fact that you can customize your case to the way you like it to look. So that's the Laser 3D LZ7 XTD, a refreshing take on the RTX case. Not only is it a case you have to build yourself, but one that you can customize for maximum performance or style. I personally like the see-through panels, as it allows me to show off my PC components, and let me see the fan spins and the RGBs light up. Yep, I'm a massive geek, I know. But guys, let me know what you think of this case in the comments below, and smash that like button if you like this video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and all the parts featured in this review will be linked in the video description down below. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'm Andy Django, and I'll see you in the next video.